all-important clash at Elizabeth between the home side, the Dogs, and Glenelg. As umpire Steve Ardeal gets the game underway, a crowd of about 7,000. McGrath tries to get it out, flatten in there against McDermott. Players stack up immediately, and the umpire is going to give a free kick for a push in the back. And the first one of the game will go to wingman Tony Steinman. The Bay's kicking into a breeze. It's a crosswind, not an easy one to kick into. Is off Bolts, Walsh. Walsh puts it in high towards the pocket. Getting underneath it is Copping. Thumped away by Hearn. Copping again. Flatten comes out with a footy. And he'll get it across now and taken there by Trevor Rowe. Thought about playing off as he butters up again. Gives the running Connolly a chance. Now on the left leg. The Dogs go to the half forward line. Back there, a fine mark by Gibbs. And Gibbs thought about playing on. No, he's given away a free kick for a push in the back. And it'll go on the outer side to, who's that going to go to over there? It appears to be Creek, Peter Creek, to put the Dogs right into attack. Off goes Fraser out in front of that player. He's pushed as well. Umpire Hilton couldn't see anything of it with that. And coming out with the ball now is Seabone. Back towards Maynard, who didn't work hard at that footy, but he's been given the mark in any case. Or perhaps a free kick.
Yeah, pretty intelligently done. He knew that if he grabbed it, he would have been caught with it. Over the top now, we see Stringer. Couldn't get boots to ball, but he gets back on it very quickly. Gives it to his brother, Wayne Stringer. That was well intercepted there by Cousins. On the outer side there is Stephen Connolly, and that's holding the ball. Two free kicks in quick succession to Tony Simons. Stephen Copping is leading. He's at centre-half forward. He has it punched away from him. Now Platten. Platten's got the run of it. Short pass. Doesn't quite find its mark. Finding it very hard to pick the ball up out there was Mark Hull. The Bays will come away though. Kernahan. It's David Kernahan. Copping. Tries to half volley it. Hearn took it off him. Players stack up and we'll see a bounce.
Been quite a lot of changes. Peter, John Seabone, another back in the back pocket this afternoon. Gart finished full back for Glenelg last week, but Chris Doozy's back there now. But Glenelg are persevering with playing Tony McGuinness as their second rover.
They certainly are. In fact, McDermott has started as their first rover, or one of the run-on players with Maynard. Maynard got that kick away. Carey using strong bodywork against Byfeen. Woodlands gives it to Carey. Graham and McGuinness. Hannum. Bowen. Well smothered by Big Super. Oh, it came off the heel of Bowen. Bit of bad luck for him, and McGuinness will take a free kick. Now Kernahan is the key. Two grabs, Kernahan, and he's put down heavily, but he bounced up like a rubber ball. Now, I don't know if the umpire is going to shift him over. No, he's going to let him have the full face of goal. So this will be goal number one for the Glenelg champion. And kicking to the northern end, that's a good start for the Bays as they draw first blood in this game.
Yes, Stephen Kernahan, of course, is at his most advantageous to Glenelg when he's up in front of that goal, where he can get a perfect result for his great marking. And once again, we see Kernahan, hands in the air, going for the ball very deliberately. Glenelg, off to a very good start. They're kicking into a fairly strong breeze. It's freshened up a little bit early in this game, but died down from early morning strength, and now she's come up again.
Garton against Cousins, a good bounce. Gardon got his hand to it but couldn't get it out, neither could McGrath. McDermott working for the ball at the bottom of the pack, and the umpire will rebound it. Conditions just a little overcast, quite warm however, considering the weather we've had. A clever tap down by Cousins, can't get it clear, and the umpire is going to give a free kick to Connolly, centre field, to put the Dogs into attack. Off goes Fraser towards that player now, Doothy with him, thumped away. Quickly in there now was number 10, which was O'Reilly, but it's Seabone who kicks the ball to the outer side. Simon's there with Connolly. Simon's appeared to drop that football. Umpire said play on. Creek now with a chance, puts it in the air in towards O'Reilly, but he can't quite get there, and the ball goes out of play in the full forward left pocket, and it's on the full, so a free kick to John Seabone.
See, they haven't had a good start to Central District. They're not attacking with that breeze at all well. Perhaps should be coming down the centre of the ground rather than on that outer side with the way the breeze is blowing. Offhand now, Johnny Platten couldn't grab it. He's back onto it now. Tony Simon got the kick away, but it was a Platten high tackle right over his shoulder. So the champion rover, the current McGeary medalist, will have a shot at goal. He's got a 15 metre penalty as well. So at the 5 minute mark of this first quarter, John Flatton has got a good opportunity to level the score. A very deliberate kicking action on that occasion.
Good goal to Flatton. Scores a level, one goal each.
Well, it's pretty handy to get a free kick, John Flatton. It was all happening up above his head then. He seemed to be looking for the ball and players were swiping it from above his head. And finally, it was he that was held. And he received the free kick plus a 15-metre penalty. And he's made no mistake with his kick, and centrals need to be accurate. Glenelg have certainly beaten them to the ball in the early part of this quarter. They must concentrate on getting possession and then trying to move it in quickly, because the wind won't do it for them.
Once more, Garson against Richard Cousins, centre bounce. Another good one by umpire Hilton. Cousins got the tap away to Rowe. Around the corner, Bubner and Gavin Walsh. Bubner comes up with a footy, drives off towards goal, puts it in long. This could be home. Oh, what a goal, Peter Bubner. Helped by the shepherding player in the square. The Dogs have come away from centre for a brilliant goal. They lead 2 goals to the Bays 1.
Well, they got the ball out of the centre very well. Then Centrals went up to that half-forward line where Peter Bubner, who was named to play full-back in the side, is playing on the half-forward flank. He's standing on Gavin Walsh, and the bounce favoured him, and he reacted very quickly to it. Once the ball was within his grasp, he took it, straightened his body, and that's a great kick by Peter Bubner.
Yeah, the Bulldogs have got Jamie Thomas standing, the Glenelg giant, Steve Thompson. It's about a foot and a half different in height there. Holding the ball, according to umpire Hilton. The free kick will go to Alan Stringer. Played a couple of games in reserves in the last month, but too good a player to be down there. Craig Woodlands leads in the race of the ball. Maynard lends a hand. Johnny Flatton at the base of the pack, where you'd expect him. We're 7 minutes into this first quarter. The Dogs leading by a goal. 49 is McGrath. Cousins got the tap away towards McGrath. He's going to get a free kick. Pretty untidy looking player, McGrath, but he's been very effective in the middle for them. Kick forward, see Stringer go up and punch away. The handball comes out, fanned over to Flatton. That was superbly put. Flatton's going to take all advantage that he can. The Garton tackle didn't stop him. The Flatton kick, though, finds Ross Gibbs, who really is a marvellous back pocket player. He reads the ball superbly.
Judged that well. Puts it up for Stringer now, Flatton there. Flatton comes out with a footy, hooks around the corner, Russell Shields, plays on quickly, towering torpedo, punt going to be close, over the top, big leap, Bubner, Seabone for the Bay. To Gibbs, off the half back line, no one to give it to, he's got to work hard for it. He's run down there by the Dog player in Mark Hull, and will get the free kick in the back pocket. Ross Gibbs looked up and could see no one to kick it to. He's happy. He's got a free kick. A high one towards Gardon. Kernahan over the top. Cousins couldn't hand him in there now. Got it to McGrath. Worked in hard again for it. McDermott in there with him. Strength against strength. And the umpire will come in and bounce the ball on the half-forward right flank for the Dogs.
The players finally get up. McGrath and McDermott having a bit of a chat. Jim McGrath has given the Dogs a lot in the centre in the past couple of games. Cousins, McGrath, Van Dommel, McDermott just repaid the compliment as we see Flatton run into an open goal. He puts it through for his second. Beautifully raised, Johnny Flatton. 3 goals to Dogs for 0-1.
So Malcolm McGrath is in the middle of the play. He's certainly going to get where the ball is. Coach Kevin Neal said last week that last year they were considering not playing him in the reserves, but he stuck with the club and he's worked his way right back through the reserves and now into the league side. And of course, at the end of that play, John Flatton in the goal square. And he's certainly going to make it know that he's out there today. He's had a number of touches already this quarter and he's certainly going to be a difficult person to stop.
His sixth kick. Centre bounce. Carey against Cousins. Cousins got the leap, got it down to Van Dommel. Craig got a handball out, straight to Wayne Stringer. Drops it onto the boot for Kernahan on the half forward line. A good mark. Out wider still now is Simons. Kernahan's going in longer, however, looking for Copping. Copping's having a lot of trouble with Hearn, who did it well to get it to Hannah. Back to Hearn in the 1-2. Settles up now. Orlock kicked into the man. Salisbury on. That was quick garden off. Copping under pressure now from three dog players, and the umpire will come in and bounce centre wing on the outer side.
Yeah, the bay's probably too much tall timber out there, Ian, with Kernahan, Thompson, Carey and Garton.
Three goals, plains a goal. Kernahan over the top. Craig got an awkward kick, not very effective. McGuinness has to work hard to get through the pack. Got it out to Simons. McGuinness in the double play. He in turn, Kernahan now back to McGuinness in the treble play. Kicks to the half forward line, not well directed, and Bunga Hearn made hard work of the mark.
Did he ever? The handball was a good one there to Graham. Hull leads and takes the mark at centre wing. Attack side of it. Oh, there's looseness. But the kick was a shocker.
Yeah, it was on though, wasn't it, Peter? He had a loose player, Stephen Colley, running into half forward, and he's kicked it backwards.
Well, a good opportunity has gone missing. That's a good spoil. I thought it was a good spoil by McGrath. The player Hilton's going to let them play on. Simons gets the kick away to Maynard. The Bays attacking on grandstand side, and it's paid off for them. Kernahan again. 11 minutes in, and he's going to prove a big headache to Brett Hannum and to the dog side, Stephen Kernahan. The runner has gone out to Ross Gibbs. Flatton's causing havoc in the Bay pool, in the Bay back line. Yeah, Scott Salisbury's gone straight on to John Flatton. The big pack forms. Graham comes away with it. Oh, he's kicked straight to Maynard. Amazing. The Dogs have... their disposal in the last 2 minutes has let them down. Now, where's Ross Gibbs going to go? He's wandering around without a man at the moment. A big punch away from the forward area. Sees Jamie Thomas bounce away for the Dogs. Gets a kick towards Bunga on it to find Mark. Yes. They're going to whack on the head for it. Plus 15 metres. Bunga will just about kick it from there if he gets onto it. Well, that's a huge kick, Peter Bunga. An enormous kick. He's offline, though. Everyone in the grandstand thought it was a goal. 3-2 the Dogs, Glenelga goal.
Made the distance easily, fine kick. Probably gives you a true indication of how strong the breeze is. Steve to Gibbs. Short to the lead of McGuinness is well passed. McGuinness on the half back line. The Bays seesawing out of defence, bringing the attack to the grandstand side. Kernahan in the middle of the pack, coming out with the ball is Mark Hull, and hooks to the half forward line. Walsh under pressure, can't get there. Big super can to Gibbs. Short goes inboard to Stringer. Stringer on the defensive corner of the square, already incurring the wrath of the Central's crowd. Gavin Walsh accepts the handball, goes to the half forward line. Dumped clear by Graham, however, back in defence. It is Butner, not Butner. That was just the phone. Play on is the call. And Cousins comes out with it to Creed. Centre field, the Dogs all smothered off the boot. Flatton's got the footy now. Dummy turns, going to run into trouble, gets out of it well. Gives it back now to Mark Hull. Hull goes in long up towards Cousins. Gets his hands to the ball, not Cousins. That was O'Reilly. But it's Carey who comes out with the ball and finds McGuinness on the half back line.
McGuinness has got a panic to move in, but Kernahan's the only one he can aim at. Kernahan with the chance now. Goes Jamie Thomas, but Kernahan's going to get a free kick over his shoulder. In the centre of the ground is Alan Stringer. He changes direction. Glenelg have been directed to keep it on grandstand side. No doubt about that. The umpire calls play on. William Hearn tries to butt the pack. Kicking off the ground is Van Dobbel. Cousins sets it up now for the running player out there is Connolly. Connolly uses the left boot to great effect. Fraser's in front, can't take the mark. Murphy off hands was good work. Doofy, should I say. Glenelg running out of trouble. On the outer side of the ground is Woodlands. McDermott. Murphy. A chance now for the Dogs. Oh, heavy work there by Jamie Thomas. Got rid of Stephen Copping as though he wasn't there. Puts it back to Van Dobbel. Now Creed. Creed's got no one to kick it to. There are bay players everywhere at centre-half back. Will Kip put it down. It's unusual to see. Great tackle applied though. And the Bays are going to run it out. David Kernahan. He got it from Doofy. Up goes McGrath. Couldn't take the mark. McGuinness, superb. But he's going to get caught. Oh, the handball was meant for Stringer, but he's on the ground. Creed to Van Dommel, the centre half forward, and Russell Shields. The Dogs are going with the breeze. I don't know, they've made good effect of it at this stage. Big Super, good mark in defence. Hayes.
Peter Carey right on the last line. The home crowd didn't really appreciate the decision, but it was there as Super gets 15 metres as well. Gets the lead from centre wing David Kernahan, but comes in field. Now a chance for Gibbs to clear. He got it from Salisbury, short to Maynard. Still on the check side of the centre line. Now to put the Tigers into attack. A high kick to the half forward line, giving Kernahan a chance. An easy mark taken out off him there by Creed, but the mark was well and truly taken. Once again, the crowd not really happy with the decision, but it was there too. Kernahan drives up towards Copping, the long arms of Copping. Get over the top of Bone. He wants to go in short. He has. It's a good pass, and he finds McGuinness 30 metres right out in front. 16 minutes gone. The Bays have got one into the breeze. And even in the reserves game, we didn't see a lot of goals kicked from this position. The breeze coming across from left to right is pretty choppy. Kick number five, McGuinness. We'll have to take plenty of that left goal post. He didn't bring his form of recent weeks. The former medalist now hooks it straight through. Umpire hardly moves. Goal to the Bays, a handy one. Two into the breeze, but they trail Central Districts 3-1.
Well, after a very brisk start by Dunelg, they sort of went dead for a couple of minutes, but they certainly lifted themselves very strongly again across half-back. And of course, Stephen Kernahan at centre-half forward continues to get those big hands in the air. And once again, it was he that created the opportunity. And Stephen Copping, first time he's got away from William Hearn, got his hands onto the ball, and over it went. And Tony McGuinness working hard as well. They certainly lifted all around the ground, and McGuinness has capitalised to keep Dunelg right in this game.
In ruck now is Grant O'Reilly against Peter Carey. A line ball situation in the middle. Alan Stringer, very tough, gets to his brother again. Wayne Stringer goes out wide. Dunelg have been instructed on field to keep the grandstand side. Stephen Bowen. Trevor Rowe or Platten. Wasn't a great deal in that. A gentle push, and Platten took the mark. Going to kick long, as you would expect with this breeze. Up goes Fraser. Couldn't take the mark. The umpire says play on. Ross Gibbs, as usual, reads it better than most. Puts it out nicely to Tony Simon. Didn't really achieve a great deal, I don't think, but here's what Simon does with it now. McDermott under the ball. Couldn't take the mark, but the umpire's going to pay it. Well, the handball missed Wayne Stringer, but sufficient time to recover and give it to David Kernahan. Possession football, the Bays. Play off, the umpire called. McGrath took it off him. Butler, McGrath. The winning player is Russell Shields. The handball missed him. Carey, cool as you like. Walsh. The Bays are certainly controlling the ball. No doubt about that. Mr. Popular. Oh, McGuinness played that brilliantly. Kernahan will be next. Great football, McGuinness. He runs through half forward onto the left boot. He didn't read the brief correctly that time. Copping. Copping's mark. What a scintillating, destructive little performer McGuinness is. He can really hurt you with the sheer blistering pace. He can carry the ball from one line to the other. His kicking generally is pretty good. Copping with a check side. No, he's got a point. 3-1 at the Dogs. Dunelg 2-1.
Tony McGuinness in brilliant form in the first quarter. Pretty hard to check side the ball into a breeze. Very difficult indeed. 3-1 to 2-1. Kick in by Thomas. Ball goes over the top of Bythene's head. Now he's going to have to work hard for it. Or Copping takes it off him. Bythene, Copping, Burn. Now Bythene, Copping went out with a heavy bump, puts it up for McGrath, and he's got it on the half back line. In turn goes for the lead on the half forward line of Hull. Went past that player. Carey lumbers back on it. Gibbs, or just got it in time. Sidesteps beautifully. Always got a lot of time. Oh, he lost it on that occasion. Now Maynard has to work hard for the ball, and he's going to get a free kick. Oh, gee, umpire Ardell not popular in this stand at the moment. As Peter Maynard gets a free kick from check side of centre wing. thought about Gibbs, but he'll go shorter to Stringer. He's had a good quarter. David Kernahan's on the outer side. Doesn't want him. Stringer will go there now. Took his time, played it well. It was kick number five. Kernahan clear. Puts it up for his brother. Getting underneath it. Hannum getting back. Kernahan too tall, too strong, too good. Another fine mark for the Bay champion. Averaging two, just over 2.5 goals a game. Kernahan already to the fore in this first quarter, as Robert Odie told him. But then again, you'd expect him to. A difficult shot. He's kicking into this fishtail breeze now. Only 30 metres out. Has booted one for the quarter. And the Bay's having a fine start. Kicking into the breeze in this first quarter. They lead by six. They still only lead by six. Not one of his better kicks, but Coppin's got the footy. Well, that's interesting. He marked the ball. I'd have to be charitable if I said that Kernahan meant it to go that way. He's obviously having a shot at goal. Now, copping from the other side. He missed the check side before. This time it could be the banana ball or the drop punt. He's looking for the drop punt by the length, looks of things. I think he threaded that one through. That's the point only.
Well, a lot of things happening up there. But, it's a bit untidy, the football at the moment, and the breeze is a bit difficult, particularly at the northern end, Robert.
Yeah, Stephen Kernahan tried to punch that ball, didn't he, Pete? And he really dragged it across instead of letting the leg go. But Stephen Kernahan and Coppin can't find the big one.
Well, the crowd are not too wrapped about the way the umpires are judging marks at the moment. I think I might agree on that occasion. Woodlands didn't have much of it. Steve Thompson couldn't get to the drop of the ball. It comes out now, though. Grant Riley kicks it long to half four. This is where the Dogs are falling down. But they break through this time. Van Dommel on the run. Oh, he hooked it. Can't miss those when you're going with the breeze. And haven't had that many opportunities, the Dogs. 3-2 to 2-2 now.
Yeah, that was a bad miss, Pete, because they need every goal they can get. And that was a lay down Mazzara if he straightened his body up. He just ran so nonchalantly to kick that through to behind.
Kernahan the lead. He's paying the man in front. Mark Hull to Platt. Kernahan looked like he had a pretty strong touch of it, but the umpire didn't see it that way. Platt now from 35, 40 metres out. The breeze is assisting. Already had a brilliant start to the quarter. Included two. Kick number eight is offline, however. Two goals, one to the champion rover for the Dogs. 3-3, plays 2-2.
The Dogs haven't started well, and now Ross Gibbs kicks to himself. He's a back pocket player. He really reads the ball superbly. Hull tries to find Flatten. Murphy, Gibbs. Gibbs fainted the handball, then gave it to David Kernahan. He concedes ground. Gets caught. Just gets boots the ball. Flatten is tripped. McDermott's all over John Flatten. It's a little bit dangerous out here. Saw a couple of signs up before. Don't Flatten Flatten, or else. 15 metres, that gives John Flatten the chance to kick a goal, but the angle is acute. He signed with Hawthorne. I certainly hope we see him back after his stint in Victoria. See, the breeze is bringing that back now. Big pack of players in the square, but it's offline. So for a point, the forward line of the Dogs here, it's doesn't look that good really at the moment.
Not at the moment, Peter. They're not using the ball all that well. 24 minutes gone. Steve-O, a good kick in to find Gavin Walsh. He's at centre-half back. Thought about playing on till Trevor Rowe thought better of it. In fact, the umpire's given 15 metres, although I don't know that he did because he elected to play on. That's a fine mark. Mark Hull. A good pair of hands. An awkward kicking style, but he covered 50 metres with it. Carey getting back in defence. He swallows those marks. And Big Super didn't let his team down again. He's at centre-half back. The Bay's playing pretty heady football in this first quarter. And they are enjoying an eight-point lead. Umpire Hartnell farming out those 15 metres. Super from the half-back line to the outer side. Stringer is the leaper. Van Dommel. O'Reilly. Body's going hard. McGrath not happy. Trigger and Van Donnell not happy. Simon and McGrath having a few little words. But the umpire is going to give a free kick. Who will it go to? It goes to Shields, I think it is, on the outer side. No, not Shields, it was Grant O'Reilly. Whoa.
The Bays are playing this defensive role very well. They've got a loose man down there.
Peter Carey it is, and Gibbs, as a matter of fact. I reckon that central distance has got a player short up there almost. Peter, they're running a long way up to the centre and leaving a loose man right back in that goal square.
Yeah, Scott Salisbury's running Johnny Platten way out as well, which is making Johnny Platten work. Now McGrath, Graham. Graham's got out of trouble pretty well. Bounces along centre wing. Cousins was it at centre half forward. He'll come over the top to that player now, but Wayne Stringer beats him to the punch. Tony Simon could sit down and have lunch out there, but he didn't pick it up. Connolly, Salisbury, under the ball. Platten interfered with him, said the umpire, when the ball was further than 5 metres away. So Salisbury free kick. Pretty tough defender, Scott Salisbury. Wayne Stringer, big pack of players now, offhand to Rowe, hook around with the left boot, Cousins, hasn't been in the game enough Cousins at this stage, Stringer, that's a bit high that one, got Salisbury, lets them know all about it, getting a bit willing out there now, Van Donnell and Salisbury on the ground, and Cousins and Sebo have a look at it. Van Dommel, I think he's all right. The free kick is going to stand, though. It's going to remain with Wayne Stringer.
He took a heavy knock, then.
Yes, he copped a high one. I don't think he cares too much for the fisticuff part of it, though. I think he's a little bit bored by all of that. Gavin Walsh leads. We're 27 minutes in. It's been Glenelg caught up. Shanahan got around beautifully, then. He had to wind through two Dog players to get in a position to take that mark, and he did it like the champion that he is. Further afield, Jamie Thomas in front. Oh, he's the mark paid.
Don't have to get much of a grab on him. Jamie Thomas from the half-back flank. Well into time on the first quarter. The lead from Budner is a good one. The pass likewise. Budner checks out of the centre line now. Shields wants it in quickly, but he's going further afield for Fraser. Leads the minute. Zuthi right there with him. Off the fingers it comes to Hull. Out of Airy. Well done, McDermott. Oh, the handball back to Murphy wasn't good. Platten meets him. Salisbury in trouble. Gets it across to McDermott. The Bay should get out of this now. Puts it up high for Kernahan against Hannum. Hannum simply too small, but is still on the ground. Is still there as he drives through. Oh, out went a Bay player quickly in. Now is Hull against Kernahan. Hull on top of the footy. Hannum wants it out. In there with him is Gavin Walsh. But the umpire will come in and bounce the ball on the half forward left flank.
I don't know who McDermott was trying to hurt then. He had himself or the opposition.
3-4 to 2-2, the bounce. Kernahan taps it over. Coming out with the footy, the ball goes to the half forward and off the boot of Hull. Now it's McDermott, kicks towards centre field. Graham and McGinnis. Graham got there first, coming to meet it and doing brilliantly there is Kernahan. Holding the ball, yells the crowd. They got their answer, they like that position. And it's a free kick. Going to Shields. Shields from 15 metres against Stringer. Now that is not good defensive footballer. Doran has sounded. But Shields is 15 metres close to goal, wasn't in reach before, most certainly is now, from 35, 40 metres it out, he puts it on its way, and the result is a goal, after the siren, his first, for a time here at Elizabeth, the home side 4-4, the visitors 2-2.
The Dogs by 14 points at the start of the second quarter, but they had the breeze in the first quarter and may have wasted it to some extent. Richard Cousins and Peter Carey. Carey played a marvellous role in as a loose man in defence in the first quarter. Good smother there and finally a kick away by Connolly. And a good mark by Mark Hull. Connolly's a runner, but I think the Mark Hull handball to him has forced the Dogs to go indirect as Van Dommel hooks it around. McDermott went for the spoil, but it's Ross Gibbs again. See that superb football. He plucked it out of the air, gave it to Maynard. Maynard now to Carey. Carey having a superb game. Big chance there for Adam Garton behind the pack, but it comes through to Jamie Thomas. He appeared to be well tackled. A fair tackle, holding the man in favour of Graham. I think it might be Hannum.
Hannum, a free kick for hanging on. Kicks to Connolly on the outer side, still on the half-back line. Looking for a lead. He gets one from Shields further afield, but he's going into Platten, who's well covered by three Bay players. Stringer back, hooks around the corner. It's very high, but ground covering. Kernahan gets edged underneath the ball by Hannum. McGuinness getting back. Within there is Graham. McGuinness close to the line, keeps the ball in play, but only got it to Hannum, and he goes for the safety of the line. A throw in on the full forward left pocket, almost out to the half forward flank.
Well, the Dogs would love to get a goal at that northern end. The Bay showed it could be done. Comes back to Jamie Thomas from Brett Hannum. Awesome underground kick that's going to clean bowl Skinner. The Dogs with a chance now. Grant O'Reilly. McGrath it was who picked it up. Jamie Thomas has had a good run from the back pocket. Now Mark Hull in a lot of trouble, but he's tapped it back very intelligently to Russell Shields. A big chance now as the mark is taken by Fraser. Maybe too far out to score. Only the big captain Peter Carey is there, and that wasn't terribly intelligent.
Gibbs off the half back line. He's always got plenty of time. 2 minutes gone. Ducey. Simon put him under pressure from Hull. Good handball to Maynard. Thought about it. Oh, great tackle, McGrath. Hull in again. He hasn't got the footing, and the free kick will go that way. Mark Hull, half forward left flank. In short is Creed, but he's going longer over that player's head. Up towards Bubner. One hand. Find Mark Bubner. Casey put one hand up. Slip down. Play gone quickly. He's got Platten in the square. Two on one back there. No call man. Here again, Platten did it well. Here at the bottom, David and Goliath. Platten was holding the ball, but the umpire will come in and bounce the ball on the edge of the square.
He has a debatable one here. What did you think? I couldn't see. We're a bit far away. Platten didn't have his hands on the football there when Carey had it. The big fella might have been in a bit of trouble.
Yes, a lot of experience there, though, Peter Carey. He lines up for the bounce. Oh, Graham took it out of the air, gave it back to Platten, or tried to, but missed him. Now Wayne Stringer clears. Tony Simon and Connolly. Connolly's a top player. He doubles around and puts it high for Platten. Platten gets out of trouble. Connolly again. See, they're not going forward with any decisive disposal at this point. McDermott, Seabone. He'll transfer to the outer side. The running Kernahan. Stephen Kernahan takes the mark. In turn, he'll look for Copping. Right on Copping is William Hearn. He plays it pretty tight, as Hearn. He was tackled well by Copping then. They're finding it hard to get out. They eventually do. Brett Hannum. That is a floater if I've ever seen one. David Kernahan. He's at centre wing. Finally decides to go long. 5 feet under the ball. Centralistic players clash. O'Reilly it is who tries to shovel it out. Finally manages to. Will Cummins stopped at his run in. Jamie Thomas playing a fine game. Gives it to McGrath.
McGrath on centre half back. Over and out of Hannum. Off the half back with all the kicks for Shocker. Well, maybe it was meant there for Creed. Creed puts out a pass. Fraser on the lead. Got cleared by Ducey, which is good defensive football. Got a butter up again. Platten in the action again. Gave away the handball, but it went to Simon Carey. Back to Simon, didn't need it. Beautiful handball to Gibbs. And Gibbs tips long to string on the half forward line. The running car, Woodland, steady. 45 metres out, goes in with a long one, but he's going to be offline for the minus score. Great running football by the Bays off the half back line. 2-3-4-4.
Well, that's the first score, in fact, for the quarter. So it's taken some 5 minutes for Glenelg to score, so perhaps that breeze is not as effective as we initially thought. Brett Hannum to Trevor Rowe. Typical shot down Trevor Rowe. Cousins should mark against McGuinness and does. Cousins hasn't had a big part in this game thus far. Good pass to Bubner. Bubner really is an exciting player. He's a fine athlete and a very hard man to stand. David Kernahan does it easily against his opponent in Russell Shields. pulls it back towards Murphy, and that's a good mark. Just the defence side of centre wing, Murphy. Just a quick back saw Murphy, and he played very well. Oh, Stephen Kernahan too strong in the air. The running player, Motlop, through half forward. Motlop puts it up. Won't score a goal with that bump. Thompson in front. That's all. 6'9" of it. Looks like a stretched version of Darryl Wadey. Stephen Thompson, same number. Number 13. He's a huge man. Well, tall, should I say. Could be that big. Through the centre, though, for his first goal. So it's 3-3 Glenelg, 4-4 the Dogs. So Mark Motlop's on the ground and off the ground. He's coming straight off. It was Peter Maynard that went off at quarter time to allow Motlop to come on. But Motlop's going off now. So a bit of good play. Gave him a bit of run through the centre. And of course, if they get the ball in long and strong and one out to big Stephen Thompson, I'm sure he's going to prove a very big handful for central distance in that full forward area. But the game is on this big oval is certainly throwing backwards and forwards. There's not a lot of scoring. Players are kicking fairly strongly. They're not able to get the ball to advantage easily. It looks like being a pretty tight game.
Terry against Cousins at the centre bounce. Favours Terry slightly, although he had to stand his ground. Cousins got the tackle away, went to Stringer. Boots the base to the half forward line. Coming to meet it, got a bad bounce with Garnon. Turned back in defence, left the football behind. Gate copping a chance. Almost lost his foot. Going in hard, Connolly. And he's going to get a free kick for a high tackle, I presume. Connolly on the half back line. He and Tony Simons having a very interesting tussle at centre wing as he breaks away on the left leg and drives towards the half forward line. Walcott knocked away from him. McGuinness couldn't pick it up. Well played, McGrath. The Butner one to beat. High tackle. Butner will get a free kick. He'll take it once the pain goes away. That would have hurt. I like the way Peter Carey picked the ball and gave it back to him after he knocked half his teeth out. Butner kicks to the leader, Fraser. Can't bring it down. Gill shoots the goal. Run fire starting to gallop. And the ball won't come back as Gibbs desperately gets back in the fix. A point to the Dogs, 4-5. Glenelg 3-3.
Gibbs to Doofy. And as per usual, Gibbs finds his man. Trevor on the mark. 3-3 plays 4-5. We're 8 minutes into the second quarter. Kernahan punches away. McGuinness with superior pace. Hugs the boundary with that one and we'll see a throw in. Centre wing. It's a good game here at the Oval. Central District Elizabeth Oval. The Dogs desperate to stay in the five and, well, as is Glenelg, of course. Carey offhand. Taps it out to Walt. He puts it over the top. McGuinness pirouetted beautifully out of that pack like a ballet dancer. Now Tony Simon. Craig Woodlands might step it, but doesn't. Bowen. Well, the Central District supporters clapping the efforts there of Bowen and Thomas in, and they really defended well.
The Green Beater throwing on the half forward right flank, Cousins against Adam Garton. At the throw-in, Cousins tap, Connolly tried to tangle out of trouble, scuttled across the bone, broke the tackle but got a forehand ball away. Stringer a good run, but the umpire has been a free kick behind play. It's going to Stephen Bones, and he'll take it on the half-back line. Robert Owen, Adam Garton pushed him in the back, he thought he might have got away, he was just a hug of the ball had gone. Bones kicked, Stringer destroys the mark from behind over Rowe, Platten. McGrath can't get it out, Rowe it was. Finally it comes out now towards McDermott. David Kernahan, here's a chance to find out wide now. Woodlands a long kick going in long, going to be awfully close. Thompson in the square. Fine mark over the top, pulled down there by O'Reilly. Goodbye, Steve.
It was a good mark, two under pressure, putting it out now to Cousins. Cousins is at right halfback flank. Oh, the kick is not a good one. He's given it straight to Stephen Kernahan. Gee, now Wayne Stringer way down from halfback. Up they go, a good punch away from Byfield. McDermott snares it. Onto the left foot. Great snap, but offline. A point. 3-4 the Bay, 4-5 the Dogs.
Central District certainly not recovering quickly enough, Peter, to recovery, particularly from defence when their players are getting into defensive action. They've got no one to kick it to. The back player, Glenelg, was too strong for them, and the Central boys getting caught well up the ground.
A
Riley's kicking is not a good one. Bone rescues the situation, gets caught on the left leg out wide towards McGrath. He goes down. Stringer straightens up, puts it out in front, copying a good pass. One, two, grab, got it. Or copying, if anything, was underneath the ball a little. But he's got long arms. And he brought down a fine mark for Stephen Grab. He's 45 metres out. Should make the distance with the assisting breeze. Get the boot one. The bay's down by 9-7 points, correction. Coffin's kick a drop pun underway. That's home for all money. Reduces their deficit to a point. Coffin's first goal. 4-5 the dog, 4-4 Grinnell.
Well, Stephen Coffin, a very good mark under pressure then. William Hearn following very closely, obviously under instruction not to let him get anywhere away, because obviously Stephen knows just how dangerous Stephen Coffin can be. But Grinnell was certainly looking with just a little bit more impressive around the ground. Their ability to get to the fall of the ball, perhaps a fraction better than Jenkins at the moment.
Ominous signs for the Dogs. There's still plenty of time in this quarter. Grinnell have got the breeze. Cousins beat Terry on that occasion, but Big Super recovered beautifully. A wobbly kick to half forward. William Hearn leads in the race to the ball. Coffin gets there now, but well evaded by Hearn. Springer punches away from McGrath. Now Simon. That's a floater, and it's marked by Hannum. Hannum is going to change direction, and it may pay off, because Mandoval's got good run. Bounces beautifully through centre. Onto the left boot. Out comes Fraser, but Gibbs is going to cut him off.
Kid Gibbs is playing a fine game. That's his 11th kick coming up. Gibbs from centre half back. Short. Susie. A long kick now from the bay defender. Goes to the half forward line. Kernahan over the top so easily. He's killing Hannum in the air. Put McGuinness under pressure. Great tackle put on that player. Thomas Cook, Cousins back, puts out the pass, and that's well directed to Connolly at centre wing. The Dogs go into attack towards the half forward line. 2-on-1 back there on Fraser, bumped away by Susie. Creed the first to recover, puts out a pass, Graham underneath it, and he's got him about 45 metres out. Elects to play on, changes tack, looking for backup support this way, that way, shoots for goal, and bottles it, I think. Offline of point, G to three, took it away savagely at the end. A brilliant solo performance and a little unlucky in the end result.
Certainly was. I just don't know if the Dogs have got the forward set up to win this game. I don't know that they can kick a big enough score against the Bay. Kernahan, David Tite runs down the outer side of the ground, looks for Stringer, and he trapped that ball very well. Now Maynard, Big Super. Daisy Cutter in towards Coffey, turn in defence, also Bowles, back to Hearn. Hearn goes short to Van Dommel. Cousins, with a handball, put him in trouble. He didn't pick it up cleanly though. Van Dommel jumps back onto the ball and got out by Grinnell. Dermot, Thomas, now flattened. Seems quite as in recent minutes. Graham, couldn't quite half volley it. Sebo, Murphy. The Bays attacking down Grandstand's side. Coffey couldn't quite get there. Bones comes over, the ball goes over for a throw-in.
The skills of both sides, not good. They're getting to a four or eight feet, but it seems that when they're getting it, they're also missing the body, and they're putting themselves under a great deal of pressure.
Kernahan, the only clear winner in either forward line, and yet the Bays are doing precious little up there as well. Out of play on the full. The free kick will go to Adam Garner, or will it be Tony Simon? Simon is elected. Might be too far out to score. He's about 45 to 50 metres. Wind assisted left to right. He's got Big Thompson in the square. He'll put it up for that big fellow. He's got a half a metre start. Big fellow gets his hands to it, but he's out marked. Well done, O'Riley. This fellow's also got a top pair of hands. O'Riley with his 15 metres comes to centre half back. Hull wants it up long. Oh, the kicker's got a good one. Got very close to the man on the mark. McDermott, good mark. Thought about Stringer, gives it to him now. Maynard through half forward line. Carey down wider still. Carey's a tear hand. No, he's going for home. Oh, it's not a good kick. Getting underneath it. Gardle. Oh, it's
think Cooper went for home, but it went off the side of his boot. Garnon trying to improve his angle by about 45 degrees. The umpire having none of it. There's the angle. Pretty astute. Only 15, 20 metres out. The breeze could help. He's gone right across the face. That could even be out on the full. Not one of his better kicks.
Kicks it a bit like a backman then.
Glenelg really not taking full advantage of this. Well, we keep talking about the breeze. Perhaps it doesn't really mean that much. Tubman, Flatten, even deep in the back pocket. We're 16 minutes into this quarter. Ron Flatten kicked two goals in the first quarter. He opened up superbly. Kicked long. Ross Carey over the top. He's playing a top game, Peter Carey.
That's the best game he's played for a long time. He's worked very hard too. He's run hard. And that's that last mistake off the foot that he kicked the guard. The only one he's made so far.
Topping. Beautifully put, Peter Carey. Moving Topping has just gone away from William Hearn on two occasions in recent time. Of course, the kick from Carey into the open space to allow Topping to run into it was very good. Topping very deliberate. Oh, he's made the distance. Straight over the top of Thompson's head. Two goals, Topping. The Bays are in front now. 5-4 to 4-6.
After two behinds in the first quarter, that's two goals straight to Stephen Topping. This quarter, there's Peter Carey that's causing all the problem. He's going off the ball now from the forward line. Have a breather. Garth will go onto the ball and do the rucking. But Carey in the back plane around the ground. He's getting himself to the ball of the ball much better than the Central District ruckman are. He's creating countless opportunities for the Glenelg team.
That's the centre bounce. Garth on against Cousins. Carey having a well-earned spell. Line ball to tap, Van Dommel through, got the kick away to the half forward line. Graham out there with Seabone. Graham almost half volley, but couldn't keep his feet. Walsh, Seabone. Over the top there comes Van Dommel, and the umpire picked up a free kick for pushing the back, and it's going to John Seabone on the half back line. Seabone will edge the ball out of defence along the outer side, or Kernahan wants it more in field, and that's the way Seabone will go, but Cousins in front. Kernahan! Oh, what a mark! How can you get over top of Cousins like that? McGinnis the running, Clark, Carey up there, Thompson at the back, and Ekpala! Oh, what a brilliant mark! 6'9" or 203 centimetres, have it whichever way you like. The big fella got a metre off the ground, has been pulled in a ripper. Steve Thompson, the man from Darwin, has booted one, 20 metres out right in front, normally a pretty good kick. Towards the Salisbury end, taking his time. The kick is just through, a goal. Sensational goal, Thompson, his second. And the Bays move on to 6-4 to the Dogs 4-6.
That was a great passage of play by the Bays. Their individual performances. Firstly, the mark by Kernahan, and then followed up by another mark by Thompson, and the goal. All created, of course, by a very careless mistake on the half-forward line for Central District by Rene Van Dommel, and he ran in and jumped on the Glenelg player. Back gave the free kick, they capitalised on it, and went straight into the full forward area to score. So Kernahan, he's had 11 kicks and playing like a rock. 11 marks, in fact.
Amazing performance. Kernahan, Garden, David Kernahan. A lot of congestion in there as Creed gets a quick kick away. Hull can't mark the ball. Stringer was dragged off it, and it's his free kick. Yes, the Dogs have got problems at half forward. I think we recognised that in the first quarter. And they were going with the breeze. Up goes Kernahan. Got the ability to hover in the air now, Stephen Kernahan. Connolly. Cousin. Love to want it in short, but didn't go come that way. Garthold. Thought about David Kernahan wide, but then he thought better of it. Why not put it up to Stephen Kernahan? Couldn't get in front on this occasion. Lord Cousins to Bone. Bone let it go. Jamie Thomas now to Stephen Bone. Tries to hook it back, and in fact, not a bad kick. Eventually got near John Flatton, but it was Hull who got the handball out to Russell Shield. The Dogs a chance now. Fraser punching away with Goosey. Now Wayne Stringer, Ross Gibbs again. David Kernahan will take his handball, and the Bays will kick out of trouble.
over towards McGuinness, set him up a little bit, but he took it well in front of Barnes. McGuinness just the check side of the centre wing on the outer side to put the Bays into attack. Off lumbers Carey, that's the way the ball is headed. A two-pronged attack up there, Carey and Topping. Topping comes out but minus the football. Back in defence, however, is Byfield at the bottom of the pack, I think. Garcia's number, and Carey has got the bottom there with him over the top. He's cut. A bounce down on the half-forward line. The Bays in attack, leading by 10 points, but it's been a hard-earned lead in this quarter, having set up a fine first quarter into the breeze. Cousins got it over there towards Maynard. Hannum on the left leg. Wobbles one back towards centre wing. Close to the line and out of play, is it? Turnahan just keeps it in. Does it well. Back to Gavin Walsh. Walsh puts out the pass to McGuinness in the pocket. And he'll have a shot for goal.
Well, Copping's going to lead for him. But McGuinness had kicked long. This is his 12th kick. Maybe too far out for him. Puts it up high. Gives Thompson the chance. The big chap. Oh, he's got it! I didn't think he had a chance for that one, but he certainly did. Held his feet, and that was a fine pressure mark in the back there. Well, he's showing that in dry conditions, the ball's put in high, but he can do the rest. That's his third goal. Steve Thompson, third this quarter. Goodell kick away now. 7-4 to the Dogs, 4-6.
Stephen Thompson certainly is going to cause a handful of trouble up there for Central Division. Glenelg can continue to get that ball into the forward line as they are at the moment, though. Complete control across the centre of the ground. Their centre line players are holding position very well. When they go into attack, instead of running up into the forward line chasing kicks, David Kernahan standing back, dropping back quickly into position. And when Central Division do get possession of the ball on the big ground, they find that the space back and across the centre has been filled by Glenelg players. The Glenelg boys have only got to maintain a little bit of disposal skill, and I feel like it gave them quite a handy lead at half-time.
O'Reilly in ruck now against Garton, approaching full-time in the second quarter. Garton got up high, got the tap away towards Maynard. Budner met him, Kernahan gave it back to McDermott. A high kick in towards Copping again. Hearn can't get there, neither can Thompson. Got a bad bounce. Hannon's been moved to full back by the looks of things as he drives back towards centre wing. Diamond's looking for it there with Connolly. He hasn't got it. Connolly fakes for the grab. And the free kick will go the way of the Glenelg Wingman on the half forward line. Peter Butler's at centre half back too, Ian.
Thanks, Robert. The kick from Simon. Woodland didn't mark it. Kernahan tackled Barnes brilliantly. Now McGuinness. Kicked mother by Jamie Thomas. Kernahan will have to get rid of it. It's held to him. And umpire John Hilton's going to bounce it. Well, Glenelg have certainly got some stars out there and working pretty well for them now. They're 16 points up. Peter Carey shepherded in the ruck, then got the free kick. This very intelligent, experienced footballer, Peter Carey.
Well, the umpire, he walked straight back into the Central District ruckman then and shepherded, which you're not allowed to do, of course. Blown me down. He's got a free, the big fellow.
The kick is coming back with the breeze, not quite the distance. Steve Thompson didn't mark it. Copping kicked it through though. And that was well done, Stephen Copping, for his third. Glenelg 8-4 now, the Dogs 4-6.
As Glenelg now takes advantage, a little bit of luck as well as Peter Carey gets a free kick when he tried to back into it. An opposing ruckman coming in and the body wasn't there. And when he tried to reach over Dotley, Central District player giving the free. And Thompson got his hands on the ball again. He's able to be read off by Copping.
The Dogs have trouble. Garton against O'Reilly. Garton tap again out towards Maynard. Almost taken off him there. The handball goes back to Stringall. Made a mistake with a hand. Running through with Shields. Left the footy behind. Battling up again is O'Reilly. In goes the body there on Stringer. Couldn't get it out. Neither could McGrath. Arms, legs everywhere there. Murphy is legs, but in between time, the umpire has come in to referee the bounce. It's on. Two little satellites bounce. Arnold comes in to help Hilton. Player just getting a little excited. But I think you'll find that umpire Hilton will bounce the ball, or is he going to give it away? He's going to give a free kick. So he saw something wrong. Or is he going to bounce it? No, he's going to give it to Alan Stringer. Well, that'll make the stand here popular. They're making popular the stand here.
because Stringer hasn't been really popular all afternoon in the Dogs' team. Got centre wing now. Kernahan got the handball back towards Simon. Finding it hard to pick it up against Clapp. That's a great tackle. No holding the ball decision given. Garton comes through. Has to get rid of it. Creed fell over. Clapp gets pushed out. So does Garton. And umpire Hilton will have another bounce.
Is that a very quick decision, wasn't it, Frigga? Yes, quite right, Frigga. The umpire very good with that. He just fell from the player's hands on a good tackle, and he allowed him to play on, which is in accordance with the rules, of course.
Hilton puts it down. Garton goes up high. Punched back by Van Dommel. Wayne Stringer. That's a high ball to centre wing. Stephen Kernahan punches away from Butler, his immediate opponent. And we'll see a throw in. Attack side of centre wing for the Glenelg side. They've had a top quarter. They've kicked 6-2 for the Dogs. 2 points. Dogs just can't score that northern end. Butler flies. McDermott in hard. Throws Butler out of the way. Oh, well done. Alan Stringer to Maynard. Down McGuinness. It's centre half forward. Woodland runs into the open space. But it may well be that Steve Thompson is the focal point now. Ball's dropping short. Offhand, Coffey's got it. Great tackle, John Platton. Stephen Bowen kicks off the ground. Hearn to Hannum. He kicks short, aims to the boundary line, and it's out on the ball.
Free kick to McDermott at the interchange gate. The Bays into attack again. Thompson and Carey and Coffey. Three big sets of hands, but the ball's going to drop well short. Brighton couldn't read it. He's got it, however. Trying to put out a handball. Hannum is the saviour at the back there. Hasn't got a lot of pace. Had to give away a handball. Not a good one. Going through Maynard. 30 metres out. Pumps away for goal. He's earned it. Oh, what a mistake in the Dogs' defence. Brilliant play, Maynard. His first. And the Dogs move on. I mean, the Bays move on to 9-4 to the Dogs 4-6.
So, Craig Woodley comes off and Mark Motlock comes on. Glenelg storming to a very good lead here at half-time. And it's all caused once again then by the defensive play of Glenelg. Their ability to stand back across the centre on that rebound kick, pick it up and then convert.
Maynard playing well. Gardon and O'Reilly. Neither player could get near it. McGuinness got possession but he was tackled well. Plenty of a lot of hard body work in there. Players all around the ball and there'll be another bounce. Jamie Thomas working hard. The Glenelg have certainly got a forward line that's working for them. O'Reilly or Garton went for the body then. Quick kick away. John Platt appears to be hurt. He's on the ground now. He's pretty tough. Maybe winded at this point. So Gavin Walsh clears for the Bays. Kernahan and Butler. Kernahan got a push in the back. And the free kick goes accordingly. John Platt's being attended to by a trainer now. Stephen Kernahan goes to centre half forward and Carey. He had it before it was punched out of his hand. My team's not impressed. Neither is the Cowboy. He's not even looking. I don't blame him. Siren's gone. Waiting to kick Peter Carey. Too short. But there it is at half time. The Bays 9-4 to the Dogs 4-6.
Ten.
A good second quarter by Glenelg when they added 7-2 to 2 points. Seasons with a 28-point lead as we start the second half here at Elizabeth. Carey, aerial ping pong as the ball thumped by Vandermel back towards Stringer. Stringer under pressure, slips out the handball to his brother Stringer. The umpire allowed them to play on as McDermott got it to Carey. Out comes Big Thompson, gets his hands on the ball. Two Bays players ran into one another, Thompson and Garvin. And whizzing off is Butner and kicks the ball out wide to Rowe. Rowe on the left leg gets the lead from Fraser going in low. Couldn't half volley it. Doozy did that one well but lost the run of play. Murphy back in defence but the umpire is indicating a high tackle against Philip Graham and he's got the free kick on the half forward line. Bad misunderstanding there by the two Glenelg players in attack. Should have been a mark and a shot for goal though. Only about 25 metres out. But the referee's Dalton clearing kick finds Michael Graham, not Michael Graham, Philip Graham in turn, having a shot for the woodwork. He's going to make the distance, but he hits the post. 1.0.
Yes, that reason, that play down that forward line end was a bad one. Steve Compton, I think, should have given ground to number 22, Adam Garton, because Garton was in front and he was unsighted, and they both had the opportunity, and the Go Central's a bit of a chance.
And the Glenelg runner, in fact, went out and had a chat to Adam Garton about it, but we can only presume it won't happen again. Or heads will fall. Left half forward now. The Dogs are going with the breeze to the southern end. Trailing dramatically, though, by some 27 points. Cherry is the best big man on the ground today. He really has picked up his game. The Dogs go forward through Peter Krieg. Doocy doing a fine job. McGrath with nowhere to go. Krieg again onto that left boot. Here's a chance for the Dogs. Oh, what a snap. What a great snap from Peter Krieg. Through the centre, his first goal. 5-7 the Dogs, Glenelg 9-4.
Peter Krieg's been fairly quiet play today. They haven't had anyone doing too much up court at all after Don Clapton's initial burst in the first quarter. But he got his foot to that ball under a little bit of pressure when he received it. He just managed to get it through the goal. Perhaps a little bit of help from the breeze. But the breeze at the moment, I would say, is slowed right down. I think it's going to be a very even second half with regard to win.
The Dogs can't get a winner in attack. Cousins got the tap away towards McGrath, who couldn't get it out. And the free kick is going to Carey. They're hanging on out wide. The run comes from Walsh. The handball just too far out in front of him. Traps as well. Drives in towards Copping. Hearn back there with him. Towards the line the ball goes. Hearn gets it out well. The running trail is Connolly off the half back line. Flat and clear. The Dogs with a big chance to go into attack now as he straightens up. Gets the kick away. FAD Fraser is going to mark the ball. In any case, no. Yes, umpire Hilton. He's going to give an FAD, but Fraser had the ball. Bit of a yike behind Fraser, but Fraser shoots the goal with that left leg. A tumble punt going to drop quickly up towards O'Brien, who's playing full forward. Stringer back in defence, claimed by Robe, and gets the kick away towards the line.
Yes, that was John Hilton, wasn't it, Robert, who came in and gave that FAD, and I don't think it was the right decision.
Me either. I think if John Platton wants to wait that long to kick the ball, the player's almost on top of him, and he only pushed him in the side. I think he was a bit fortunate.
A throw in, left half forward flank for the Dogs. This is the time they must get back into the game. Peter Carey controlling the aerial work. Ross Gibbs again, what a first half he had. Now McGinnis, that's a free kick if I've ever seen one. I think it may have been met in the final analysis by Jamie Thomas. He normally hurts the players he ruffles up, Jamie Thomas. He's a real hard defender. McGinnis. He's limping a bit now, McGinnis. Through comes Van Dommel. Jamie Thomas won't stop that from going out. Yes, McGinnis is limping noticeably. Walking back through centre wing now. I think Peter Carey comes across. And Mark Hull. Super is too strong. Michael Murphy tries to find Maynard. He goes down like a school case. Put into towards the centre of the ground. McGrath, Stringer, and Murphy. Glenelg clear again. Bubner. Well, Kernahan did that very well. He was out of position. Hearn. Bubner again. The Dogs tear away now. They've got a chance on this grandstand side. Trevor Rowe and Peter Carey. A lot of courage from both players. Van Dommel didn't know. McDermott was there. And that was a great tackle.
Well done, Peter Carey. Neither player would give in. Good solid footy and a brilliant tackle there by McDermott. But you expect it from the Bay player. Plus 15 metres. Robert Odie.
Carey's not going to let anyone know he's hurt either. Just have a look at the big fella there at centre half back. He's really tough. He's aggressive. He was a dead head on clash.
Tough football. McDermott looking for Kernahan. Maynard got it forward. Motlock tried to half volley it. Comes back towards Kernahan. Motlock got their first caught on the left leg, well spotted by Bone, and the ball is out of play on the half-forward left flank. 9-4 playing 5-7. Kernahan and Cousins. Cousins clever tap away, but it was Motlock who winds through the pack with pace hooked in towards the half-forward line. Going to be a loose ball. The bounce good to sign. Ducked away there by Connolly. Back to Garden, caught on the left leg. McGinnis spins out of pack. 9.5, the Dogs 5.7.
Not running too freely, McGuinness. I think he copped one earlier this quarter. He seems to have less leg problems at the moment. Brett Hannum has been moved to fullback. That happened in the second quarter because Kernahan was just so dominant. Now McGrath. This tussle with Alan Stringer has been a good one, but I think Stringer's had the better of it. Wayne Stringer ran past the ball. Van Donald dangerously puts it out in front, but recovers well. Now Flatten with the run. See, that was well set up. The kick is to centre-half forward. O'Reilly punches away, and now Doofy. Glenelg are too strong down that back line. They've got too much composure and too much know-how back there. Too many players, in fact. Murphy. Hull. That was a high tackle, and Murphy will get a free kick.
Number 10, Rucky Grant O'Reilly. He played up at that end of the ground for the whole match. He played during the second quarter as well.
Yes, they had him on Tall Thompson trying to stop the big fella from marking, but he did particularly well. Booted three goals. Buckner left it behind. Runners up again for the footy. Gets out the handball too far for Graham. Gets through again. Goes down a screaming heap. Holding the ball. Right out in front of goal. Great place to get it. Phillip Graham would easily make the distance from here. Wind assisted, although the windsock on the outer side of the ground is pretty limp at the moment. The wind has definitely died since the start of play, but if anything, still favouring the southern end. Phillip Graham, kick number 6. Dogs need a goal and need them quickly. His first, 6-7. They trail Glenelg 9-5.
Ross Gibson does very well then. He got to the ball and coming through with it. But when he had it in front of his body and he got his hands onto it, then it's trying to push the ball away or hit it away. He just hung onto it and let the player ride him into the ground, or he pull him into the ground. The umpire decided that Gibbs made no effort to get rid of the ball, and instead in fact tried to break with the ball when he took possession. Therefore, he ruled he'd had the opportunity to get rid of it. So, holding the ball and the goal to the Bulldogs, and they're still hanging in there.
Richard Cousins has been beaten by Peter Carey today. Big Super has come back with a vengeance. Alan Stringer very strong in there. Van Dommel with good touch, but it's left to Wayne Stringer to get to his brother. Alan Stringer puts it out in front of Motlop. It's well put too. Stephen Bone on Motlop. Motlop recovers very well. Byteam with strong body work. Jamie Thomas changes tack. The Dogs looking a little bit better. Shield. Hull and Murphy. Hull put it out in front of him. Murphy takes it off him. Now Doofy. If it sticks, Doofy gets out of trouble beautifully to Carey. Carey will find Simon. Simon will go over the top to Walt. Back to Simon. Now Maynard. He'll run into trouble. The kick away though. Looks for Kernahan. Kernahan's got it now. Buckner fell over at the wrong time. Kernahan with a shot at goal. Won't score with it. Oh, Thompson! What a mark! These arms must be 3-4 feet long. What an incredible mark. Gee. Four marks he's taken. Have they been any good? Need a stepladder to stand this man. Cowboy Neil is a little bit worried about the situation down there, obviously. He just hasn't got a man that's tall enough to stand Big Steve Thompson.
The Bay's taking advantage of his height by putting it in high. 15 almost looks small in comparison. Cannon, the new custodian, went there in the start of this quarter after O'Reilly left the scene. He's a full forward. Trevor Rowe on the half-back line. 10 minutes gone. Edges the ball out of defence to Cousins. Well, the big fellow took it too casually, put himself under pressure, but got the handball over to Graham. In turn, Craig got a bad sit on it. Conley, Rowe, Graham, they haven't achieved much. Now Graham's going to kick longer. Goes for the half forward line to the lead now up there of O'Reilly. Can't quite get there. Coming through McGrath against the tide. But it's Simons who comes out with a footy, gives it to Maynard. Back to Simons in the double play. Leading is Coffing and also Thompson going in towards Kernahan. Can't get there. Coffing back to Kernahan. Kernahan now puts out the pass beautifully. Put down.
too good at the moment. Although Dogs' quarter has been a lot better. They've got two goals in this quarter. The Bays have only added a point to this stage. But Gardon is right out in front. 11 minutes gone. Shouldn't miss. The breeze not nearly as bad as it was. The umpire said he's homed his first. The Bays 10-6. Central District 6-7.
Well, Glenelg once again rebounding very well, but the difference in this quarter, of course, was something they didn't do all that well in the first half. That was their advantage play, their ability to run the ball down the line of the ground. And on that occasion, when they went out of half back, the Simons got the ball, they went much straighter and more direct at the goal, and they finished their play much better, something that they hadn't done in the first quarter except for the occasional good mark.
Well said, Robin. 6-7 the Dogs, Glenelg 10-6. Big carry up, but it's Cousins that got his fist to the ball. Carey doing great work in there. Alan Stringer wobbles one out. Cousins again. Oh, McGinnis tackled him well. Simon. Not quite sure what he intended then, but it didn't come off. McGrath. Strong body work, McGrath. Puts it out wide to the running Fraser. He's had a nightmare of a day. Doofy. Oh, Murphy missed it. Got a bad bounce. Down went Simon. Players stack up. We'll see a bounce. Left half forward flank. 43 plays 66. Glenelg leading by 23 points, and that's a good lead. Carey again. He's just far too strong. Far too good today, Peter Carey. Van Dommel. McGrath. Thomas. Trouble. It's one of those occasions when you don't really want it, because you know when you grab it, you're in trouble. Graham. Well done to Fraser. Here's a go for the Dogs. The kick is into the pocket, though. Bebo under the ball and it's out of the ball.
He's going to get it either way. See, the Dogs have got problems up forward. Little method. Platten's booted a couple and they've got four with singles. Edged the ball out towards Carey. Thumped away from that player. Simons performs his own little bit of magic as he gets the ball back towards Stringer. He's playing pretty well. Wolf runs him into trouble. Connolly. Back now to McGrath. McGrath tries to set it up again with a pass to the half forward line. That's better put, and that's a very strong mark taken by Trevor Rowe. Fraser off, can't get into the action. Collins is on, wants it in the pocket, but he's going in towards the other pocket now, setting himself out there. His shield hooks around the corner, but it's not a very good kick. Collins, Platten shoots for goal, but it's offline for 1 point.
Yes, Johnny Platten's not able to dominate in this match. Chris McDermott is doing some fine work on him, and of course he's also got to contend with McGinnis. There's a bit of a dust up in the centre of the ground. Peter Carey and Mark Hull having a not too friendly chat as Ross gives it over to Wayne Stringer. Very loose. Down goes Carey. Carey is on the ground now. Umpire John Hilton's come in. He's having a chat with Cousins. Peter Carey's going to get a free kick. And at this stage, we don't know whether there's been a report. Didn't appear to be. Carey puts it out wide to Kernahan. A little bit of excitement there.
This is where Stephen gets a bit wide sometimes. Pete, they kick across the ground to him because he's such a good mark. He doesn't have to run that wide. Although Stokes Butler's got a bad play on him now.
Right, Copping goes to centre-half forward or Motlock. They let it go for him. Was very well led, in fact, by Maynard. Motlock is at centre-half forward. Nice kick into the square. I'll put the money on Steve Thompson. Off-hands off. Took it off-hands. Throws it. What a performance by the big man. He's got four now. 10-6 the Bay. 11-6, should I say. The Dogs 6-8.
Well, Peter Market, that's a statement of the year. He had no hope of getting that ball. You said, I'll have the money on him, but no jitters hit the ground. The big fellow, he's got his big sharp bag out. He put it in his bag and run up to the goal line and kicked it over. Magnificent performance by the big fellow. Followed all the way to the ground, that ball. The Mills are maintaining that form that they showed in the first half. They're pretty confident today.
Byneen having a run in ruck against Peter Carey. Cousins has gone back to full back by the looks of things. He's on guard on or standing that player. McGinnis spins out of the pack towards Maynard, but Van Dommel gives it across now to Connolly. Kicks long to the open spaces, looking for Hull. 2-on-1 out there. He got his hands to it. Recovers well to hook the ball back in towards full forward, but gee, that's well out or well offline. In fact, he could have just landed into touch. the goal umpire indicates to the boundary umpire that it was out on the full, and it's Seabone's free kick.
16 minutes in. Gee, Seabone might as well just stand by that point post out there, because they're kicking it out on the full on every occasion. And the umpire Hilton will bounce it. Left half forward flank for the Dogs.
See, John Seabone, very calm in defence, isn't he, Peter? He makes a difference back there. He does it so easy. When he puts his hands on the ball, such a definite play.
I agree with that, Robert. Van Dommel. Now Rowe. And are they having problems in attack, the Dogs? They can't get a winner. If you've got no winners in attack, you can't win the game. 8 kicks. Trevor Rowe puts it up high, lets the breeze do the work, but it doesn't. It's a point, so there it is. 6-9 the Dogs, 11-6 the Bays.
Over 15 minutes gone, and the Dogs with their last use of the breeze. Although, as we mentioned, it has died considerably. McGuinness, Flatton, the two champs again to one another. High tackle on Flatton. Might be too far out to score. In fact, I think he would be. Off goes O'Reilly, but aborts the lead. Flatton's 16th kick. Gee, it's a mammoth kick. That's going to be awfully close at the back of the pack. It was Gibbs and Walsh close to the line. The umpire said he wasn't over. And Doothy comes away with a ball in towards Stringer. McGrath. Doothy. Graham. Shield. 40 metres out. Steady gives it a chance. It's just at the woodwork. Bad luck for the Dogs. Beautifully set up there by Philip Graham. Well done the heavy work by McGrath, but the Dogs can't find the opening of the goals.
They can't take a trick, the Dogs. They're in a lot of trouble. And as McGrath has been holding his forearm for some considerable time. We haven't seen Scott Salisbury for a while either. I don't know whether he's
on the bench, I think, Peter.
He's probably there. I'm just wondering if he's injured in or...
Yeah, they put Ross Gibbs back in that back pocket on the Rovers now.
The kick is to centre wing. Oh, the man in front. Murphy played well on Mark Hull. It's a high ball. Kernahan, Bubner in front. It's the place to be against Kernahan. Connolly. Concedes a lot of ground, Connolly. And he has to kick back. Shields. McGrath. Has a bounce. Now Jamie Thomas. Back to McGrath. Run through half forward. He may have used Philip Graham then, but he changed tack to Peter Creed. Peter Krieg is playing his 99th senior game, and this is his 10th kick. He kicks the ball well. It may be beyond him distance-wise. Well, it's a lovely kick. Through it goes for his second goal this quarter. 7-10 the Dogs, 11-6 the Bays.
The central districts are still hanging in there, even though they can't get any run through that half-forward line. Mark McGrath certainly working very hard in the centre of the ground, and as he came through half-forward, then he held his leg up. Gave a very nice kick forward to Krieg, although I thought the handballs that he did earlier, the first one he gave, was certainly undernourished, and it didn't give his teammate a chance to run on down the ground.
Carey back in ruck against Bythene. The big fella has to wait, but he's still got the tap away. Over towards Kernahan, Motlop and Flatton. He hasn't got the footy. He's got it now underneath him. The umpire will come in and bounce. Central crowd believe that he should have got a free kick for hanging on previously. A bounce down marginally in the attacking division of the Dogs. Carey got that tap away, but it went back to Shields. Shields conceding ground, finally gets the kick away. Not well directed. Stringer says thank you. Has time to set it up. Off goes Copping out in front of that player. Getting back on it. Oh, beautifully done, Copping. Close to the ground. Will dispatch. Oh, he's asked to play on. Backing up beautifully. Simons boots it in high. Gardon sets himself. Thompson over the top at the back. However, it was Cousins. Slipped out the handball. Here's a chance now. Maynard, open goal. Oh, how did he get that? Maynard's second goal. Cousins' handball went astray. And the error was fully accountable to Maynard, who put it through for his second goal. And the Bays are 12-6 to 7-10.
They'd say no more after that, Ian. Richard Cousins will want to saw his arm off. He gave a very quick handball, but it was certainly well taken by Peter Maynard. He was at top pace when that ball came to him, but he snaffled it and scored.
A big error. 26-point deficit now, the Dogs.
might be throwing his weight around. And also the man in there is Collins, Peter Collins. A rebound, 37 is David Kernahan. Bythene got up very high. Tony Simons with a run of it. Centre half forward, the man there is Jamie Thomas, a good defender. McGrath wants it on grandstand side. If he gets it, he'll be lucky because the kick wasn't too flash. Oh, beautifully read, John Platt, but he was off. He was off.
Free kick go back.
Yep. It was picked by John Hilton, and it was well picked too. Against Gavin Walsh. Kicks back over centre wing. Bubner and Kernahan, two great players. McDermott, McGrath, McDermott, Maynard. A left boot that will probably find McGuinness. It's the Bays. The Bays have got more know-how out there. They give the impression they know what they're doing. Whereas the Dogs haven't really got a game plan. They're just pushing it forward and hoping. Steve Thompson has it punched away from him. It may be pushed over the line now. Yes, it is. A point. So 7-10 the Dogs, 12-7 the Bays.
Ominous signs. The Nilga attacking into the breeze and they're eking out their lead. Hannum. Simons getting underneath the ball, good mark, head up all the time, showed courage, looking for a lead, gets one from McDermott, off goes Thompson, he's going towards the big fellow, oh, Copping got his hands to it, couldn't complete it, Bythene, Copping over the top, Bythene close to the line, Hearn got a long handball out to Connolly, in turn he'll find on the half back line Krieg. The Dogs running out of defence with a long kick up to Platten, there is Collins as well, nobody got their eyes on it, all Platten plays on. To Van Dommel, back to Platten in the double play. He gives it out wider still. Hull, 30 metres out, sets for goal. It's a shocker. Riley, over the top comes Sebo. Buttering up again is Hull. Out he goes. The umpire said, push it to back. Oh, he got out of that. How he ever got out of that, no one will ever know. But oh, the kick. You would not give it 2 out of 10. But he's won a free kick for a push in the back, close to goal. And the Dog supporters breathe easy. Oops, round on the angle somewhat. Well, after his previous kick, neither the Cowboy or I are very confident. I think he's missed it. That's a defender's kick. A point only, something the Dogs didn't need. Wouldn't do anything for their confidence or Cowboys.
He's giving the Wrigleys a fair whack at the moment. I'll tell you what, he's not impressed, the Cowboy, at the moment. And this is a game that he really needs to win. Seabone goes out wide. Punch away from the Central District player. Peter Collins traps it very well indeed. Gives himself the space, and that'll just about bring rain. Up goes O'Reilly. Couldn't take the mark. Van Dommel missed it on the run through. O'Reilly's got it now. Here's a go for Shields, but did he keep it in play? Yes, he did. Van Dommel, nowhere to go. Graham, Platten wants it, but he won't get it. That's a throw. Shield puts it on the boot. I can't believe this. It's still in. Now Johnny Platten's got a chance. Couldn't get down to it. The ball comes out now to Toothy. He's going to run away with it. I tell you what, there's no way known the Dogs can win this after that. Bubner. Fell over, now McGuinness. Well, that handball puts Stephen Kernahan in bother. McGrath, I think, is feeling a little bit sore at the moment. Peter Carey's got it at centre-half forward. Copping leads, and Copping will get it. Peter Carey really is a superb player, and put that ball beautifully to Copping. Steve Thompson now, the big man. Hannum over the top, Motlop through. The ball comes out to Hannum. The Dogs will clear.
Coming away now is Bohm. Kicks long towards centre wing. A long lead from Collins out there, but he won't get to the ball before it goes. Or he did, yes. Close to the line is Rowe. McDermott the tackler, but he gets the kick away. Platten can't. Gibbs can. Plus 15 metres, I would think, against John, who's just showing a little bit of frustration. We've said it before. because he almost looks tall against Platten. Gibbs, Garden, oh, he ran off, ran into trouble. Shields, did a Stanley Matthews, not with much effect. Garden over the top, still trying to wrestle the ball clear, and the umpire will come in and bounce. 26 minutes gone, Liddell 12-7, the Dogs 7-11.
We're seeing some amazing things, aren't we, from both sides. Players not really feeling where their opponents are. See Adam Garten then running into a player. In their effort to try to get the ball in, they're trying to run to do it. Their ability to get it onto their teammate accurately is not good.
McGrath coming off. I had the feeling it was a bit sore. Replaced by Pittman. There'll be a throw in at left half forward flank for the Dogs. They're trailing 53-79. There's McGrath, Malcolm McGrath. A Dog discard of recent times, but he's come back very well. Garten and Hull. Wayne Stringer, a very reliable defender. Super work there by the Glendale player in Simons. The Bays go forward, Copping again, and they're putting the ball very well to Stephen Copping, and he's obliging by telling marks. Now Steve Thompson runs into the open. Copping's taken 8 marks, in fact. The ball runs over the line, and we'll see it throw in the right forward pocket for the Bays.
Only about 25 metres around. Close to three-quarter time. Kernahan. His side's got a 26-point advantage. Carey is there as well. Probably go against Cousins for the throw-in. Fythien at the back might come over for the scissors. No super. Try to grab it to get a kick away. Tapped it out too far for Kernahan. Quickly in now is Hearn.
Gave it back to Bubner, left foot out of defence. But the ring of confidence is there for the Bays. Maynard got it to Stringer. In turn, Garnon. Simon, he's dispossessed, and the umpire said holding the ball. Wasn't really a good attacking movement. Boehm elects to play on as he goes out wide to Collins. He's on the half back line. Not much to kick to. Hull now gives the lead in short. Stringer might upend that. No, Hull, good mark. Slips out the handball. Van Dommel puts out the pass on the half-forward line. Pittman, his first kick for the afternoon.
Really got no one to kick it to, though, Ian. The Hull ran right down to the defensive side of centre. There's no one back there. Flatten having to work hard. Just a whole ground.
They're actually running backwards. A lot of the central players, Stephen Connolly, when they're getting possession of the ball and they're running away from their goal, they run another 20 metres back into their defensive side before they get onto the line of the ground, and there's no one running on a direct line to receive the handball. They've got to get that going if they're going to get right into this game.
David Kernahan can't take possession. Johnny Platten gives him a hug, but we'll see a ball up at right half forward flank.
18 shots to 19, Pete. There's only one shot in it, but Glenelg's 12-7 is indicative of their smoothness of movement into attack.
Agreed. Mark Hull and Adam Garten. He punches away. Graham. Give it plenty of time. Now here's a chance. Shepherding in the square. No, Riley's decided to take the mark. He had the option to try and kick Seabone out, but Seabone wasn't going to let him. So O'Riley took a fine mark. Might blow a bubble in a minute. 5 kicks, O'Riley. That's his first goal. So at three-quarter time, the Dogs are 8-11, trailing Glenelg 12-7.
Good to talk to you.
The Dogs are down by 20 points at the commencement of this last quarter. A vital quarter of football for both clubs. The Dogs need a victory. McGrath is getting ready to return to the arena. Looked a pretty sore boy when he hobbled off midway through the third quarter. There he is. Not the tidiest of footballers to look at, but he's quietly effective, although I think Alan Stringer has had his measure today. Carey, best big man on ground. Rene Van Dommel, stolen by Stringer. Jamie Thomas, really good player. A rebound to Peter Carey. Maynard was bowled middle stump. Now Connolly
is running sideways again. Peter then hooked it around his body and he just got the distance.
5 is off. We're about to be off.
He's had a bad day, Peter, but I think he can't get near the wall at all.
The kick is from Hull. Super Carey getting back
doing some great work. Running into the pocket is Johnny Platter. The ball beats him out over the line.
Throw it in the right forward pocket. The Dogs in attack. Down by 20 points, needing goals in a hurry. There's not much in the breeze now. O'Reilly got it out to Pittman, hooks around the corner. Umpire getting underneath it, going across the face of goal. There is Collins, Stringer over the top. Collins and Stringer quickly joined by Rowe. Now hooked back in towards Platton. Well, I don't know whether it was meant for him or not, but it was beautifully put. Platton low to the ground. Kick two in the first quarter. Kick number 19 coming up for the Dog champion. Head on to goal. The Dogs need him right now. Oh, the umpire starts to move, but he's got it okay. That's his third. The Dogs are still in it. Make no mistake about that. They trail 9-11 to 12-7.
Well, that was a great bit of play then in the forward pocket by Peter Collins initially. So close to the boundary line he was. He looked to have no room to manoeuvre whatsoever. Finally ran the ball back across the ground. I forget who was.
Trevor Rowe.
Got that ball across to John Platton so well. It was a tough mark too because it was really wobbling at John and he put it onto the body very well. So Centrals are holding out this quarter.
They never give in, the Dogs. Certainly not against the Bays in the earlier game at Football Park this year. It was John Platton who got two late goals to give them victory. Now Shields takes the mark right in the centre of the ground. Connolly wants it on grandstand side. Graham takes it offhand, plays for the free kick, not there. Here's a chance, Trevor Rowe again. Ross Gibb punches away. Hull, Court, Cole, no decision. Johnny Platton again. No free kick there either, and the umpire's going to bounce it.
Tucked his head. Umpire saying, no, no round the neck for that, John.
Mark Hull was lucky too. He had the ball when tackled. Just appeared to get rid of it. The mouth down as a 10.5 forward. O'Reilly and Carey. Platton again at the bottom of the pack. Kicks off the ground. Over the top of John Seabone. Over the line. And we'll see a throw into the right forward pocket for the Central District. And Ian, they're still attacking.
Incredibly, Peter. Now 14 points down. We've said so often they haven't got a winner in attack other than Platton, who's carrying the ball into attack. Big leap up there by Cousins. Pittman, he gets dispossessed. The umpire didn't see the push. Quickly now Collins, this way, that away. Gives a handball across to Graham. Graham under pressure too. He's under enormous pressure. Hooked back there by Shields, but it's well taken, Seabone. And he kicks to the lead now of Stringer on the outer side. Stringer and Craig have got the benefit of the bounce. Craig puts out the pass. Platton again. He can't quite get there. Beatles after it. Dummies. Couldn't get round Gibbs. Rowe close to the line, back to Platton. Platton going to check side, comes around, straightens up, hooked in towards goal. What's he done? 1 point only. Oh, what a marvellous solo effort. Throwing everything at the base, but he just couldn't quite make the grade.
They're putting a lot into it at this stage, the Dogs, and they'd really need to start converting because no football team can play at high pressure for too long without results. Particularly in a pressure match like this, so they'll need to get going pretty early if they're going to win it. Seabone kicks long, 70 metres. Peter Creek now playing centre, couldn't mark the ball. Kerry handball is intercepted, but the Bay's running out through Murphy. Here's the run now with David Kernahan, running through half forward, trying to set it up. Coppings in the middle of the pack, punching away Barham now. Butner, he's got the pace to run away. Pittman might get it next. McDermott missed him. Pittman, Shields, Collins running now. He's through half forward, Collins. Here's a chance. He lines up the kick as a shocker. It falls short. Oh, Ryan Riley's marked it, but not paid.
Marked it, but not paid. He nearly marked it. Just flew out of his hands. A very wobbly kick. Peter Collins a couple of years ago, Peter, we thought he was going to be a very good player, and he hasn't had a lot of opportunity since then. And that kick was certainly a little bit loose.
10th game, Gibbs, can't get it clear. Some of the Bay players not running all that well at the moment, getting a little tired. 12-7 to 9-12. Important game for both teams. The Dogs lose, they could slip out of the five. They probably will, depending on other games, of course. McDermott, Walsh, got it from Kernahan. Hull,
David Kernaghan again. McGuinness, a high kick to the half forward line. Kernaghan, who's been pretty well held by Butler in the second half. McGrath got out the handball. Here's a chance now. Cousins shoots for the lead in towards the forward pocket. Thumped away from Rowe. Kernaghan getting across to the ball, close to the line. Took the heavy bump, took it well. Now he's going to get a free kick for a high tackle.
Defence side of centre wing. The Bay's under pressure now. They've got the big guns up forward if they can get it up there often enough. Woodlands. 6.5 minutes gone in this last quarter. Woodlands swings it into towards centre half forward. Cousins, two grabs. They're expecting to mark the ball against McGuinness. No one there for the Bay's. Stephen Kernaghan led to the outer side. And it wasn't put to him. So Cousins brings it back now. Simon's in front. Should mark. Paid by the umpire. Simons gives Stringer the run. Now McGuinness next. McGuinness is on his right foot, which is his wrong foot, but he swings it back. Brett Hannum. Up he goes. Oh, he dropped. Got Brett Hannum. It was Cousins. Hannum in there now. Fighting hard for the ball. It comes back to Cousins. Now Hannum. Also Pittman. The Dogs run it out. Super Carey is lurking back there at centre. Can't take the mark. The Dogs are certainly fighting. They're holding ground. Graham gets out of the pack miraculously. Collins tries to put it over to Cree. Cree fell over. Simons finds half court and gets a free kick for a high tackle.
Tony Simons on the defensive line of the square. Salisbury back on the turf as Simon goes out and finds McDermott. The running player, Kernaghan, doubling back. This is David Kernaghan over the half forward line, goes in long, getting back on it, coughing. In front is Bohm. Hammond wants it, but Bohm gets the kick away. It's not a very good kick and trickles out of play in the full forward left pocket. 12-7 to 9-12. Corns looking worried. Set up the platform at three-quarter time, but they're not taking advantage of it. 8 minutes gone on the final quarter and his lead has been reduced from 20 to 13 points.
Left forward pocket, Cousins and Thompson it was to the Bays who went for that one. There's a free kick in there for holding on. It will go to Butner. He's played very well on Stephen Kernaghan. Kernaghan had taken some 12 marks in the first half. He's been a very dominant player. That kick may come off. Van Dommel, Pittman, Butner with pace, blistering speed, and there he goes again, Connolly. Conceding ground, brings it back. Krieg and Collins. Now McGrath. Shields it was who got it out to McGrath. He's got a bit of pace too, McGrath. Runs through half forward, puts it out beautifully to Trevor Rowe. Well, they've still got some steam, the Dogs.
What a beautiful movement. Peter, he ran straight at the goal then. McGrath with pace, trying to accelerate right at the goal front.
12th kick, Trevor Rowe. He's put it up. It's coming back. He got a lot of distance with that. Touch. Touched on the line. Johnny Platton doesn't agree with it, but it'll stand. 9-13 to 12-7.
Yes, you don't see umpires change their mind very often, if at all. 9.5 minutes gone, final quarter. The kick into the outer side. Van Dommel, McDermott got the thump away. Simon against Bubner, cleverly. Kernaghan, back to Simon. McDermott, Simon could get it next. No, it's going to be David Kernaghan, the base running the ball into attack. Kernaghan now puts in a long one up towards Thompson, the big fella behind. One grab, couldn't complete it. Quickly now, Bohm is in. Close to the line, but the ball runs out of play in the full forward left pocket. 12-7 plays 9-13. Carey off. His efforts obviously not appreciated by the home team supporters. Thompson got the tap away. Coming in hard, Simons. Cousins over the top, tried to tunnel ball it out for McGuinness. Back in defence, it was Thomas who got the handball away, but it went out of play once more.
He's had a big day, Peter Carey. Best big man on the ground easily, and I imagine he must be pretty tired because he's pretty important to the Bays, particularly with the way he defends. Gets down and blocks up. He gives them some method out there. Van Dommel, Brett Hannum,
thought they were going to run it down grandstand side. Yes, they are. But Grass is going to get run down. Didn't appreciate the body behind him. It was Scott Salisbury who just replaced Craig Woodlands. McGrath has been hit from pillar to post today.
Got to accelerate again. Peter, one of the things about Jekylls, hasn't they? They've evaded, and then they haven't gone on to finish the play.
They're in a bit of trouble at the moment. They just can't get the score on the board. Or Thomas got out of that just. The wobbly old kick may not come off, though. Wayne Stringer, very reliable. Gives Copping the chance. Oh, Barb in front. Superior judgment. It's a telling mark, that one. Here he goes short to Van Dommel. Maynard. There's a lot of Glenelg players who haven't touched the ball for a while. Van Dommel. Pittman or Graham. Take your pick. Graham's got it at centre wing. The run is on. Pittman now. Didn't need to fall over. He can get up, run off if he wants to. Well, he didn't bring it, no. He didn't kick that at all well. He kicked it straight to Ross Gibbs.
He's got a magnet on the ball, that man.
Gibbs at centre-half back, goes out wide to Kernahan, who appears to be having a run on the board. At least he's at centre-half back at the moment. McDermott, Stringer will get it next. That's Alan Stringer. Clear on the half-forward line, trying to set up the play. Puts it out in front of Copping. Bone right there with him. Motlop the pace. Hood back. Motlop looking for backup support. Hooked around the corner, going in high. Going to be short. Thompson there. Thumps the ball clear. Thumps it through his goal. It may have been Hannum. Either way, it results in a point to the Bays 12-8. The Dogs 9-13.
The difference is 13 points. The Dogs just can't get any closer. And they have to play pretty well to win this. Black, two grabs, good mark.
He has a good glide. Jeez, the power of those legs, Pete.
It certainly is. He's got cramp, though.
That's because he took off with the power. I bet that really tested the muscles from the front spot. Because I say the McGinnis is no weakie.
22 kicks, John Flatton, and he can't take the kick, so it's been given to the big chap, Richard Cousins. It's not a good sign for the Dogs if Flatton has got the cramp, because they'll need his run to win the game. Just now, David Kernahan has been at everything in this last quarter. Now Maynard. Salisbury. Tackle is on. Flatton is right on him. He won't let him go. Ball is bottled up in the pocket. We'll see about.
That's real footy, isn't it?
Like a bulldog. That's grabbing at his heels.
That's
what a terrier. Running with cramp and all. Vitean about to re-enter play. A bounce down on the right forward pocket. The Bays in attack. Cousins gets the thump away towards McGrath. Salisbury the tackle. Put on a good run again. Quickly in now comes Simons. Flatton back in the action very quickly indeed. He appears like he's run right through that cramp. Cousins coming off. Vitean on. But Cousins will certainly go for the ruck throw in to start with. Over the top came McDermott. Gave out a handball. Maynard through. Or runs into a pocket, out of a pocket. Hooks very quickly in towards full forward. And the umpire indicates that the Bays have got another point. Cousins off. Vitean on.
Peter Maynard perhaps could have straightened up then, Pete. He didn't take full advantage. He went around the corner. That was a beautiful dodge he did initially.
Now Connolly. He was way up on his own for that kickoff. Graham, he's got the pace if he can get a clear run at it, but Walsh won't let him. And Walsh will get a free kick for a push. The Dogs just can't get any closer. 14 and a half minutes in, they trail by 14 points. Carton is in ruck. Kernahan is certainly still at centre-half forward. He runs wide. Probably mark that one. You'd have to back him into that situation. Stephen Kernahan, Copping leads. Graham's got a lot of pace. Copping recovers first, though. Here's a chance for the Bays. McGinnis. You go around to that left foot. Good. Left the ball behind. Flatton did it well. Now Van Dommel. Three. Pittman. Pretty good play by the Dogs to get it there. Pittman often falls over when he gets it. Kick gives Trevor Rowe a chance. He's in front. The punch comes. Collins. Got out of that one pretty well. Put it back to Krieg. Now Collins in the clear. Here's a chance for the Dogs. Collins goes long. That ball's coming back. What a great shot at goal. Well, there it is. It's the one they wanted. Collins got his first goal. 10-13 the Dogs. Glenelg 12-9.
So the crowd are coming to life here in Elizabeth. You can hear them roaring.
And fantastic footy by the Bulldogs. They're trying to hang into this game. 23 shots to Central, 21 to Glenelg, and Peter Collins off the interchange bench. A great goal.
8 points the difference, 16 minutes into the final quarter, and it's a different ball game. The Dogs in with a big chance now as they seem to be finishing on better. The tap away came from Bubner. Platten got the handball out, running behind. Free kick, and the crowd goes mad here at Elizabeth. Platten puts out the pass in towards Bubner. Bubner! 40 metres out, he's been given a run in ruck. He took the centre bounce.
I think it's because Kernahan's got onto the ball, Ian, and they put Byfeens at centre half back on Adam Garton, and Peter Carey's in the interchange bench.
Kick number 12, Buckner, and an important kick for the Dogs. 8 points down. He's only about 35, 40 metres out. The breeze now is really of no consequence. Buckner towards the northern end, and Elizabeth. All the kick underway is going to fail. It's just a punt. Graham Corn can't believe it. A point only. Bad luck. 10-14. Plays 12-9.
The Dogs have got a bit of a run now, and the breeze has died. Graham Corn's there, very concerned, obviously. The runner's out again. Kernahan, big leap, no mark. For the handball, missed Creek from Connolly. Creek butted up well, though. Now Maynard, Simons. Dinners and Tide Bay players out there. Kernahan, Maynard, two of them. The Bays with a big chance there now. Coffey, Barmore, Bowe went for the mark. Gee, how about that for confidence? Gartner's in trouble. Coffey was tackled. He's in trouble himself. Kick away doesn't go anywhere. Saul Freed, McDermott. Onto the boot, McDermott, but he's kicked it out on the floor. The Bays are a bit ruffled.
Under pressure as well, Peter. An important game. The pressure's really on. Peter Carey having a spell at the moment. He'd love to be back out there again now. Don't know the reason he's off. Maybe, as Peter said, he's just simply tired. Kernahan at the back, got his hands to it. A push in the back against Kernahan. The umpire won't let Shield play to advantage. He's going to bring the ball back some 50 or 60 metres.
Do you think that perhaps the coach has made a bad move by, in fact, bringing Garton on and putting Kernahan onto the ball and put Butler right back into the play? I think Kieran might come back onto the ground pretty soon.
He's going to change it all. Creek boots him into attack. Getting back on it is that Mr. Cool himself. And Ross Gibbs. He'll slow play down. Carey back onto the turf. Gibbs looking for somewhere to park. Simons gives him a lead short. He's going for McDermott, but they'll come over the top there. Thump the ball clear. Simons raising very tired legs. Kicks the ball centre field. Maynard's got to wait for it. Over the top came Rowe. Shield put off the ball, didn't have the cherry, and he's got a free kick right on the defensive line of the square.
McDermott coming off, gee. Carry on, so the Bays have got four big men on the ground now. Trevor Rowe. The Dogs are running. Rowe with the left boot. Puts it up to O'Reilly. He gets a hand to the ball. Gibbs caught. Got out of it like a magician. Pittman lines up. That's straight over the top of the umpire. His first goal. The Dogs back in business. 11-14. Glenelg 12-9.
Well, what's Graham Corn going to do now? And what are the players going to do? They've certainly gone for a bit of height on the ground. They're looking for a bit of movement. Carey's got to take over the ruck. Perhaps the shifting of Kernahan from centre half forward may be counting against them, but the one thing's for sure, Central Districts are coming. The little blokes, Pittman and Collins, who come onto the ground, are certainly running the ball for them and providing very good link opportunities.
The Bays have got both Carey and Kernahan on the ball. 1 point the difference. They go into attack through Rowe again, up towards the half forward line. Platten has to play on. Gibbs back in defence, kicks the high ball back towards Kernahan at centre wing. He's got to stand his ground. Oh, what a courageous mark. Head up the whole time, boots it across. Maynard underneath it. Oh, he let it go. Knocks it cleverly. Garland is going to have to work hard for this ball. Bohm has the pace. Maynard in. Upsets Bohm. He can't keep his feet, and the ball trickles out of play. Dudley Corns. Oh dear, what have you done? You could lose it after seemingly having won at three-quarter time. The Dogs are coming back strongly. Throw in. They haven't had a big history in the close ones, and a free kick is going against Glenelg. It'll be taken by Peter Fifteen inside the half-back line.
In fact, in games won by less than a goal, there have been six of them. The Dogs have won five. The Bay's obviously won, so the history book supports a dog win if it's a less than a goal margin. Butler's right in this game. The Bay's have been losing the close ones this year. Connolly into the centre of the ground. Oh, Collins not paid the mark. Peter Krieg wobbles one away. Telling kicks now. Platten tries to run it out. Puts it back. David Kernahan held ground and there'll be a bounce down. It's in the Dogs attacking area. Just the Bay's forward line is in disarray now.
Well, there's no one up forward for Central. Gibson's back there for the loose one.
Through goes McGuinness with pace. He was dragged. There'll be a free up ground. Stupid tackle on that occasion by the Dogs. So Maynard's got it at centre-half forward. And, of course, they've got the big guns down there. Steve Thompson's lurking. Copping is thinking about a lead. It's a gigantic torpedo punt kick. It comes off hands. Hearn, Motlop. Oh, the Dogs have got the run of it. Brett Hannum can't pick it up. He can now. Oh, he's hairballed out. Butner, McGuinness. McGuinness is starting to get into the game now. Hooks it around the corner. Thompson on his own and he takes the mark. What about playing on? But he realised that he was within range. Oh, so is Maynard. He thought about him. Kick may not make the distance. Kernahan up over the top with a big mark. Well, the value of Stephen Kernahan never more evident than on this occasion. Being sent around by umpire John Hilton. 15 or 14 kicks, Stephen Kernahan. He won't miss. That's his second goal. The Bays go 7 points up. The Dogs still a chance though. We're not yet at the time off.
As Stephen Kernahan, he kicked the first goal of the day, and what a great mark that was as he came in down the ground. But just showing how important, in fact, I think that's something like about 16 marks that he's taken this afternoon. But the importance, of course, as far as Central's are concerned, that the player who was on him, that was alongside him, Malcolm McGrath, on that occasion, he just had to make sure that that lad didn't get the run at the ball, which he did. And unfortunately, he wasn't able to do that, and Kernahan took a great mark from Thompson's kick. And I think that might just give them enough leeway. Time will tell.
Desperation staked out there. The Bays get it. Breeder. McGuinness trying to get his boot to the ball. Platten over the top. The two champs in there vying for the ball. And the umpire will come in for the rebound. Coming up to 24 minutes. 7 points in favour of the Bays. A place in the five at stake. A bounce down. Favours actually Kernahan, who's trying to get a handball away. Taken by Van Dommel. Beats Walsh. The kick is a loose one. Coming to meet it on the outer side there is Stringer. Stringer now one to beat all. Gets out of it well. He's been a fine player as he puts it back towards centre wing. Fine mark, Shields. And he's got an attack side of centre wing. Goes for row in short. At the back is Stringer again, a high over the top. Gavin Walsh getting back. Slips out the handball back there to Murphy. Murphy under pressure. Goes for Walsh. Walsh left puts it out of defence. And the mark taken by David Kernahan on the half-back flank.
Cowboy realises they're in trouble still. They appeared to have a chance a couple of minutes back, but the Bays have steadied. 24 and a half minutes in. There won't be much time on. A great deal of scoring in this last quarter. Alan Stringer taking plenty of time. Puts it out to Simons, and that's well put. Tony Simons has been a good player. Copping leads into the pocket. That's beautifully put again. So the Bays are maintaining possession of the footy at the moment. Of course, that's pretty important. Here's Garton on a lead, and he's got it. So good disposal by the Bays as they edge closer to the goal. Graham coming off. Cousins going on. Goal here will probably make it game, set, and match for the Bays. Garton kicked a goal in the third quarter. Missed that one. So the Bays are up by 8 points as we just run into time off.
Yes, Pete, I'm just having a look at the goals. There's been 3-4 goals this quarter. Won't be a lot of time on. The Cowboys starting to get worried, and rightfully so, but gee, they got back in the action. A few more straighter shots and they might have been in front. 15 underneath the ball, can't mark it.
Players go down on a heap. 15 comes out with a footy, but the umpire will come in and bounce the ball on the half-forward right flank. The Bays in attack. 8 points up, hanging on there despite a brilliant fight back by the Dogs. Or perhaps more determined than brilliant. Carey, an important man back on the turf. Salisbury hanging on to Carey by Cousins. The big fellow didn't have it, and Super will take all the time in the world. Time is on the Bay side.
Interesting one too, that when Coulihan's dropping back into defence at this stage, Butler's staying with him, which is something that Central's haven't done all day. Maybe too late now.
Coughing leads, but Carey's going for home with a long one. He's got Thompson in the square. The big fellow can't get his hand to it. But the Bay seem to have rested Central's last minute dive for this game and are shooting for goal, and that's a 9-point advantage now.
The Dogs will have to control the ball for the rest of the game if they're going to win. Getting under the ball out there is Cousins. He takes off, uses the left boot into the centre of the ground. No, there's Stringer again. He's played a fine game. Thought about it then, as Jamie Thomas came in late. 27 minutes gone. It looks like a Bay victory. Gee, Stringer's gone straight out to the outer side of the ground. Not a bad move, actually, because it's either McGuinness or out. McGuinness has got the run. He can kick a goal from there. Won't get this one, but he's got a point. So the Bays are on top. They've recovered and have maintained a little bit of stability at the right time.
Tony McGuinness had memories of Glenelg a couple of weeks ago there when he got one through with a magnificent back screw. That wasn't a bad kick either. He's a little bit unlucky. What a great burst of speed so late in the game.
Well, the Dogs are going to need 2 goals to win it. They're 10 points down. They won't have time for enough scoring shots other than goals. Carey comes out with a footy, tries to run the gauntlet, can't get out. Platten can't raise the tired legs. Kernahan goes down. Platten's still in there. Like a terrier. Kernahan comes up swinging. Thomas in there. We've got a yike into time on the final quarter. It's desperation stakes, and there's a lot of pressure out there now. Carey goes down. Right on him there is Van Dommel. Now the umpire's right on that. It'll be interesting to see how they see it. It appeared that Van Dommel ran into it, but who's going to get the free kick? It's going to Van Dommel, is it? Or Thomas falls off. He's got the footy. That's all that counts. Goes out wide. Rowe at centre wing. This way, that away. Needs support. He's got out wide. Cree's got to stand his ground. Got the mark. Cree on the half forward line. 15-metre penalty, or is it? Cree, 28 and a half gone. Too far out to score from here. Puts it up in the air. Looking up there for a big leaper, but Rip Ross gives again. A push out. Free kick against Fennell for a push. And what an important kick this is for Grant O'Reilly. 15 metres out, right in front. Seconds ticking away. The suspense is unbearable. Siren's on. The Bays have won. The kick of the no real importance, but O'Reilly from point blank range. Guides it through, but the Dogs' courageous comeback has come unstuck with a second goal there from O'Reilly, and they'll fail by 4 points, and a very relieved Graham Corn, who have at last won a close one. Final scores at Elizabeth, 13-12, 90 the Bay, 12-14, 86 the Dogs.